Hi, my name's Jasz Pike, and I'm a module leader here on the Game Art Degree course at DBS Institute. Today we're going to be looking at some basic UV unwrapping principles using Photoshop and Maya. So let's jump right in. So now I'm just going to jump into Maya and start exporting a UV map for a basic 3D primitive shape. So within Maya, I'm going to create a new scene. And up in the top left, I'm going to create the primitive cube icon. With the middle scrolling on the mouse, you can zoom in and out. If you hold Alt and click the scroll button in, you can pan around. And if you hold Alt and left click and drag, you can move yourself around the object. The next thing is moving and scaling the object, which are basic controls. So using the shortcuts on the keyboard, W, E, you can see the widgets changing, and using the W we can see we're on the translate, so we can move the object around. Holding Alt and left clicking again to drag around, middle click mouse button to move, and then just scroll to zoom. With this object selected, we can come up to the toolbar at the top here and we can click on this icon, which is the UV editor. Alternatively, the UV toolbar at the top, you click and come down to UV editor. This will open up a secondary window, which as you can see is a 3D cube that is unfolded. So one of the things to be aware of within Maya is, depending on where you are clicked, what object you have selected and what window you are in will change the options available to you. So within the UV editor window here, if I right click, you can see certain options available. If I right click and hold in the perspective view over here, you can see different options available. So just be aware of that. My personal practice, I like to click off and then click back on. So click off, click on. And you can see this changing in the UV editor window over here. So within the UV editor window, I'm going to right click UV shell, and I'm going to click on the object within that view. And then come up to image and UV snapshot, and this will bring up a secondary window with options for us to export this unfolded 3D object in a 2D perspective to then move into Photoshop and custom paint. So the file name, I'm just going to click browse, and I'm going to make sure that it's somewhere where I know where it is. So for me and purposes of this demonstration, desktop, I'm just going to call this J_UVMap1. Save that. Then the image format, there are several different options here. I'm going to stick with default settings for the sake of this tutorial. Apply and close. Now it doesn't look like much has happened, but in actual fact, if we come to our desktop now, we can see we have our J_UVMap1. So that's the process of a simple primitive shape, seeing it in a 2D perspective in order to create this UV unwrapping and then exporting it over to Photoshop. So moving over to Photoshop now. I've just opened Photoshop. I haven't selected anything else. I'm just going to click open, and I'm going to navigate to where I saved that file that I just exported. And it's just here, J_UVMap. Click open. And as you will see, it's opened the image. Now this might be a little bit tricky to see. So there's a few steps that you want to take to set up the visibility of this and then start custom making your textures for it. So within Photoshop, over here on the right hand side, you will see a section called layers, and under this layers tab you'll see layer 0. With this layer selected, I'm going to go down to the bottom here, and I'm going to click this little half circle, and I'm going to select solid color. This will change the entire thing to a solid color. I'm just going to change this down here to black. Click OK. Now you'll notice I can't see my UV outline. So if we just move this color fill layer, click and drag it below, you can now see the outline of that cube. So that's how to set up the visual, just so we can see what's going on. Now, if we wanted to paint some custom things on it, we need to create a new layer, make sure that the order of those layers are correct, and then we can export that. So down at the bottom on the right hand side here, there's a little square with a plus in it, and if you hover over it, it says create new layer. I'm just going to create that. make sure I label this layer by double clicking on the title of it, texture. Now, one thing to watch out for within Photoshop is once you've got multiple layers and you start editing, it's going to edit the layer that you have selected. So before you start editing, make sure that you have the correct layer selected. So again, I'm gonna select my texture layer, which is now on top. I'm gonna come over to the left-hand side. I'm just gonna choose something like a brush. And then down in the left-hand side here on the color, if you click on that, you can change the color. We'll just stick with red for now, so it's nice and obvious. Now, within each of these squares, I'm just gonna create something that represents dice patterns. 1, 2, 3, 4. I appreciate this is very, very quick, so not exactly the neatest, but just for the purposes of this demonstration, so we can see the process rather than the artistic creativity. So, with that painted on, I want to make sure that this is in between the layers of the UV outline and the colored background. So, you can click and drag your layers on the right-hand side here, and you can move them up and down. And you'll notice that if I drag my color fill layer above my texture layer, my dots have disappeared. So play around with this, but always make sure you have your layers in the correct order. So we've imported our UV map from Maya into Photoshop. We've created a new layer on the color background so we can see the outline of the UV map. We have then created a new layer called texture, and we have created our custom bespoke textures within this. Just a quick example here. So with that done, I'm just going to deselect the outline of the UV map because we already have that in Maya, and so we've got our colored background with our texture layer on top. Then I'm simply going to go file in the top left, save as. I'm going to navigate to wherever my project folder might be, but for the purposes of this document, for the purposes of this tutorial, again, I'm just gonna make sure it's on the desktop, and I'm gonna name it again, something slightly different, UVMap_J. I'm gonna click okay, and that's now saved. So that process within Photoshop is how you would import your UV map from Maya, create a layer, create a custom texture, save it, and essentially by saving it, Maya can read Photoshop files, so it's exported. Now, jumping back to Maya, I'm just gonna minimize this UV window for a second. And again, making sure that I click off and click back on to make sure that I am exactly where I wanna be. I'm gonna right click and hold on the cube in the perspective view. I'm gonna come down to assign new material. I'm gonna choose Lambert. And then over in the right hand side, within the attribute editor, you will see the properties for this material that I have just assigned. So under the first common material attribute section, there is a color parameter. And on the right hand side, you'll notice these black and white checkered boxes. So within the color parameter, click the checkered box and you'll be presented with a new window. Simply click file. And then on the right hand side, you will see that the options have changed yet again. Under the file attributes on the right hand side, you'll see an image name field with a folder icon to the far right. By clicking that, it will bring up a file directory explorer window, and this is where you can now navigate to that exported or saved version of your Photoshop file. So mine was on my desktop. I put an _J at the end, so I know it's that one. I'm gonna click open. Now, I've clicked open, so technically I've applied that texture to my model. However, within Maya, you can't see that texture. And this is another thing to watch out for in regards to making sure that these icons within the top of the perspective view are selected. Now there's one icon which is a circle, which is checkered. And if you hover over it, it comes up with the word textured. If you click that, you will now see this texture that has been applied to our 3D model. It's also worth noting that because we're using a Photoshop file within Maya, any updates to the Photoshop file within Photoshop itself will be represented in the 3D view, the texture within Maya. It's also worth noting that the textured view keyboard shortcuts can be changed using 4, 5, and 6 on your keyboard. 4 is wireframe mode, 5 is shaded, and 6 is shaded with texture maps. And you can see as I press my keys here, the image within the perspective view changes, and the icons at the top of the window changes too. So let's have a go live updating. I'm going to come back over to Photoshop, making sure that I have my texture file, texture layer, selected. Just going to use a simple brush, change the color to blue, and do something within each of these just so we can see that there's some changes that have been made. So, file, I'm going to save, I'm going to come back to Maya, and I'm simply just going to move. In fact, I didn't even need to move it there. There we go. You can see that the blue dots are on each side of that dice and it's live updated. So again, I can come back, I could undo all of this, file, save, come back to Maya, and it's live updated straight away. So there's some cheeky little tips on UV unwrapping from Maya, custom building your own texture within Photoshop, and then reapplying it to your model within Maya. So hopefully that'll be helpful to those of you new to UV unwrapping. For more information on the courses we do here at DBS Institute, check out the website, and don't forget to like and subscribe.